proof of in the Hindu religion. They say everything else will fall short, won't prove God or disprove God. It all falls short, always will fall short, because God is something that only can be only be proved if you, not your prophet, not your leader, you encounter God first hand. Means you say, yeah, I know, I see God. Then you can be sure about God. Otherwise, you can't be sure about God. So the Hindus are open. You see the power of Hinduism. It doesn't say, you because you have to believe it's written in my book. He said, no, until you see God for yourself, you have to say, I'm not sure. This honesty of the Hindu religion. It's honest. And it's very, very, people love that. And they're saying, it's not just because your prophet saw God, that's good for your prophet, not good for you. You haven't seen it yet. You may use his teachings to give you some guidance and make progress to see God for yourself. The aim of religion is not to believe in God, but to see God, experience God. That's the aim of Hindu religion. Yes,
Like, when people, like, for example, all the books that people say are holy and they read and everything, for example, if... Like a long time ago, if they were written by humans, could it have been like, as you said, that it could be for example, Cinderella? It might not be true, so it could be kind of a fake story. So they could have written it accidentally, and we still believe it today. So you have to be really kind of careful about it.
You are very, very sharp. That's exactly right. In fact, this is how we divided our scriptures. Remember when you're talking about Hindu scriptures, we said there are two kinds of scriptures. Scriptures which are presented or produced by people who say, we see God, we can see God. They claim we see God. And then they say, whatever they say about God, after they've experienced God, we say, are the scripture of authority, Vedas. This is how we get the word Veda. Veda comes from Vida, means to know, means I see God, I know God. And when they talk about first-hand knowledge of God, and they talk about it, that's called the Vedas, the scripture of authority of the Hindus. See? So, we are very clear. And if suppose somebody says, I'm not seeing God, but I want to write about Hinduism, write stories, we say, fine. But these are not scripture of authority. That's why they're called the Smriti scriptures, or like stories, but not God business, not God knowledge. So the Vedas are the one that say, if you see God, not forget the old people, you know, who saw God with beards and all that. Suppose you started seeing God. Right? You say, it can't be true. It can't happen. Oh, it can happen. You experience God. You'll go, way, like that. And then anything you say about God that comes out of your mouth is the Vedas, the purest of Vedas, books of knowledge about God, because you are talking from first-hand experience. Now, the best thing about Vedas is, if you can't see God for yourself, at least you are going to listen to somebody who has seen God himself or herself. It can be a woman. And that's the openness of the Hindu religion. So they said, if you can't see God for yourself and you still want some help, then only focus on those people who have seen God and who are talking about God. Because then you are reasonably safe. It's still not good enough. It doesn't prove God until you come face to face with it. It doesn't prove, but it gives you a way forward, how to progress. Follow the teaching of somebody who is old, or who sees God himself. Then you are reasonably safe. But again, as this little young lady said, suppose that they just made up a story and you thought that they have seen God and maybe they have not seen God, and just writing a story and you get caught up with the story, you believe in the story, you are in trouble. That's the risk we take. So we are very careful about classifying scripture of authority as that material that comes from people who see. That's how we define a rishi. The founders of Hindu religion, the figure of authority of Hinduism, are not people who write stories or tell stories. The figure of authority of Hinduism are not people who do lovely stories of Ramayana and Mahabharata. They are lovely storytellers. That's all. Are people who say, we see God. Then you talk to them and listen to them. And that's the heart of Hindu religion. It still doesn't prove God. But it gives you, if you like, a way of exploring this and finding God for yourself. I'll take her and then you. Yes.
If you do experience God, isn't it like a bit too shocking to like handle?
It is very shocking. It's very true. People who experience God had great difficulty. It's not an easy experience. You know, there are stories in the Hindu tradition. You may have heard the story of Chaitanya, one of the person in ancient India. Only about 500 years ago, who experienced God. And then, you know what used to happen to him? You know, his pores, nobody gets sweat coming out of your pores in the skin. Actually, blood used to ooze out. Blood, because he was so thrilling an experience, he can't bear it. He's blowing his fuses. This is the language. So it was very dramatic. So some people actually struggle when they see God. They say, oh, it's a very dramatic experience. But some can take it. So, I mean, the example given in your book, first page, you know, Ramana Maharshi, was establishing good experience all his life, very gentle, very simple, yet experiencing God all the time, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. These are the real founders of Hindu religion. And he lived only about 50 years ago. So you explore the life of Ramana Maharshi on Google and say, wow, what? And you see the photographs, you see a little video clip as well. You say, these are the people who could actually experience God. And whatever came out of their mouth is the scripture of authority, the Vedas of the Hindus. That is not proof of God for us, but at least an indicator that somebody has seen it and has given us a way to find God for ourselves. And the only proof is you find it. Otherwise, full stop, you are still struggling.
Does that mean anyone could create a Veda?
Yes, anybody can create a Veda. In fact, the aim of this class is that all of you, of course, become rishis or rishikas if you are a girl. And, of course, you experience God for yourself. And then when you open your mouth and explain God, to try and talk about God, the purest of Vedas will come out of your lips. Yes, it's a living scripture. Vedas are not dead scriptures sitting in the library. They are a living scripture. You experience God for yourself and talk about it. And that is the purest of Vedas. Modern Vedas. You may speak in Gujarati or English, whatever. That's the Vedas, not Sanskrit even. This is the openness of the Hindu religion. It's so open and dynamic and very honest. You see why it's so honest? With other religions, they struggle. They're trying to prove God with using this argument and that argument, try and explain suffering away. It doesn't work. Hindu religion is very blunt. It says it doesn't work. None of these arguments work. Only way you can be sure about this thing called God and religion is to come face to face with it. And the lovely Sanskrit term that you may want to use if you want 100% is called Sakshatkar. You get first an encounter of God or spirit. Then you can be sure. Otherwise you say, I don't know. Be honest. This is the honesty of Hindu religion. So when you get philosophy, Hinduism comes out like a winner. Very honest and open. Doesn't insist, he's written my book, says you have to believe. Say no. You may believe or you may not believe. You may agree or you may disagree. You may be an atheist. Good for you. So Hinduism doesn't have any problem. Dawkins says, good for you. You don't need to believe unless you come face to face with it. And we are not forcing that you have to believe or you're going to hell or something. We don't tell nonsense like that. You grow and try and make sense of the world. And then only you are sure, then you believe. Somebody else wanted to ask something. It's okay. Anybody else want to comment on this thing? Yes, they agree? No. But you see, the reason why I told you that this module is very interesting to study is because it allows you to think for yourself and gives you permission to interpret, understand religion in a way that makes sense to you. Now, the various ways you people try and answer saying, oh, this is the proof of God, etc. Almost every way, apart from the way that you experience God for yourself, will fall short, will fall flat. You can knock it out with arguments, as we just tried various ways. Every time you try, somebody can knock it out. And this is why you should study this subject in this very structured and systematic manner. Now, there are two other arguments that are offered sometimes to try and suggest there is definitely a God. One of them is miracles. People say, we can be sure about God because he is the only one who can do miracles. Ordinary human beings can't do miracles, but God can do miracles. So you say, give me an example of a miracle. What do you mean by this? And the standard example given in many religions is they say that, look, somebody was very ill in my family. Very ill. He was about to die or she was about to die. And the family got together and we're doing prayers and worshipping God and praying to God, please, please save our relation. And they were praying very hard and furiously to try and save the relation. And then somehow the relation got better. And they get tears of joy saying, ah, see, we prayed to God and God helped us. And that's proved God is for real. Because we prayed and he created a miracle and this person was saved. Of course, she's going to argue straight away. Yes, go on.
I was going to say the other person would argue that how can we believe that this is a real miracle that's taking place?
You know, she's ahead of everybody. This is exactly what they'll say. Maybe that person is going to get better anyway. Always, out of 100 cases of serious illness, there are always 4 or 5 where people just get better themselves. Or the medication worked out. Just works out. They get remission, co-remission. So they get, thank God they're alive. They survive. And always, in some cases, out of 100, of course, 3 or 4 or 5 might survive. Just like accidentally and some of the medication works. So it's nothing to do with miracle. The fact that you're praying, it just happened that this person survived. So that doesn't prove that there is a God. She's becoming a very good atheist now, very fast. The thing is this.